Hi everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to generate and read a QR code image using Python. So basically QR code or a quick response code image is a type of image which stores a large number of data within a single image. It can be a link or a text or a number or the link of any website or of your any blog or of your any YouTube channel. So all of this data you can put it in a single image. So for generating and reading a QR code in Python is very, very easy. Okay, so for this we will be using two modules. First one is the QR code for generating the QR code image, and the second one is the PyZ bar, which is used to decode or to read the QR code or the barcode. It's a very useful module and we are gonna use that for our project. So before getting started, you have to install these two modules via the pip command. So you can open your command prompt and there you can write pip install a QR code. This will install the module into your PC. Right now I have already installed the module, and subsequently you can install the PyZ bar also. So pip install PyZ bar. This module also I have already installed, so now it's in my system. So let's we will first generate the QR code and then we will read that particular QR code only. So to generate that will be, as I have mentioned, we will be using the QR code. And proceeding further, please like, share and subscribe to this video, because your like and your views, your share, it inspires me to make a lot of creative videos. So please do like, share and subscribe. So let's move forward. So for that I have to import the QR code module. So import QR code. Next, what you have to do is let's take one input data. So I'm mentioning input data as suppose you want to give any kind of data in it, whether it can be a text or a number or a alphanumeric. So I'm going to give here an alphanumeric. So let's give any random input data. Hey, this video is made by me at 1:30 PM or AM, whichever you want to specify, or any phone number you can specify. So this is my input data. Next, what you have to do is we have imported the QR code module. Now we have to create an instance of that module. So I'm creating an instance. So like suppose QR is equal to QR code dot. If you are new to this module, what you can do is, I'm currently using the Jupyter notebook, so it gives a facility to see what all functions, what all classes are available inside a module just by pressing the tab button. So see here, I can see what all things are here. So I will import this QR code class from it, and what you can do is you can specify the arguments in it, like version. Suppose I'm just providing the version as one. Also here you can decide what dimension your QR code image gonna have. Like suppose you can provide the border is equal to, I'm providing just with a single instance or the value one, and the box size, like what should be the overall dimension of the box or the QR in which the embedded QR is there. So like suppose if I give it as 5, okay, so I have instantiated this QR code module. Now what you have to do is you have to add the input to an image, right? So for that, what we will do is we will simply write QR dot, and we will use here the add data method. So again press tab and QR dot add see add data, and here you can specify the input data that we have already written here, like this input data. You can put it here as the argument, input data. So we have successfully provided the input data. Okay, now this method, sometimes we can use it and sometimes we if you wish you can't. Okay, but better idea is to use this method. Why? Because it has several parameters, like when you will press the tab, you can see that one parameter is there, that is fit. So fit is equal to you can, it is a boolean parameter, so you can boolean type parameter, so you can specify true or false here. Fit is equal to true means how much the data is there, like it will compress it and then it will put inside the image, so that the length of the string and the image size doesn't gets different. Okay, or else like a situation can be there where the dimension of the image is small but the length of the string is very much large. Okay, so in that case there is a chances of loss of data, right? So to avoid those circumstances, we use the make method specifying the parameter fit is equal to true. You can see here there are other parameters. No, there are no other parameters, so it's only fit is equal to true. Okay, and now next we only have to call a function make image which will make a QR code. Okay, so I'm calling it as img is equal to QR dot make. See, there are several functions here, like make, make image, make impl, make map data, mask pattern. So all these functions are provided, but here we will be using the make image because we need to create the QR code. So img is equal to QR dot make image. Now here there are several parameters, like we can customize it. So fill is equal to, like you can fill what kind of the foreground color you want to have, but in the QR code generally black is the only by default foreground color, and for the background you can specify any image, not image but rather we can provide any color. Okay, so fill is equal to same as black, I will specify, and for the background or the back color, there is a parameter back color, back color is equal to, suppose you can provide either white, blue, yellow, red of your own choice. I'm providing here like suppose yellow. Okay, we have seen the white QR code, let's see the yellow QR code. So I've specified the back color as yellow, let's see. Yes, it is successfully implemented, and now the final step, we need to save the image. So I'm saving this as img.save. okay, and you can specify the name of your QR code, suppose my QR dot, and specifying this extension, image extension, as .png. So my image is saved. So let's see. So see, this is the image that we have made right now. So its background is yellow and the foreground is black. You can also change the color also. So for that you can just specify up to back color. Suppose I want it as cyan. So our image will be made as cyan. See, the back color of the QR code is of color cyan. Okay, and this is our QR code generated finally. Now so this overall image, the overall code was for to generate a QR code image. So let me comment it. So So this was for generating the QR code image. Next, what we will do is we will read the same QR code and let's see what we have input, whether the inputted data is same or not. Okay, so let me comment it. So we will read the QR code image. Okay. Now for QR code image, as I mentioned, we will be using the PyZ bar. So here we will import the PyZ bar module. So import PyZ bar. Okay. Or rather to import the function also out of it, so which makes us easy to not write a complex or a long sentence, rather to use only the designated function. So I will be importing the PyZ bar dot PyZ bar. See, there are several classes are present here of the same module. Their scripts are there, tests are there, wrappers are there. We'll be using the PyZ bar. So PyZ bar dot PyZ bar. Actually it will be from PyZ bar dot PyZ bar. We will import the decode function. So see, there are several functions here, but we will be importing the decode function only. So basically this decode function returns a list of you can say tuples, or generally it returns a list containing several other data also. We will see here. So let's move forward. Now we have successfully imported it. Now for this we have to, you can either import the pillow module or the CV2 to read an image. Okay, it's up to you, your choice. And the most interesting fact about PyZ bar is, and especially the decode function, is you can either provide the image using the OpenCV or using the pillow. It has both the flexibilities. Okay, so next we will do is we will import the CV2. So import CV2. Make sure that you have installed this OpenCV module. Using the pip command only you can install it. So I have imported the CV2. Now what I can do is I have to read the image, right? So I will read the image. Im is equal to CV2 dot im read. And there we will have our myqr.png, and we will read it. So image has been successfully read. Now as I mentioned, decode function can either read the pillow image or as well as the numpy.nd array image also, that we can see here. We have used the CV2 module and it uses the numpy, it represents the image in the form of numpy.nd array. So we have imported our image, we have imported our module. Okay, now next is we will decode the image. Okay, so I will specify it as qdata is equal to decode, and I will provide the image out of it. Okay, before extracting the exact data out of the QR code image, let's see what kind of data it gives us. Okay, and here I will write qdata. So see, you can see here it is providing a list, but there are several other informations also contained in it, right? What are the data? See, the data is in the unicoded part. The byte, it is of the type byte. Okay, so it provides the type, what type of image is it, and what are the coordinates, what are the region of interest is there, what is the height, width, everything is provided here. What are the points, exact points for this QR code. Okay, so you can see here it is not the much clarified data, right? It's a list containing all the information, but we need only the exact information that we encoded inside the QR code. So for that, what you can do is you can either use the for loop or the list comprehension. I will be using here list comprehension because it can be written in a single line and it's very much fast, you can say. So here we will be using the list comprehension. So I will store it in a variable res. So I will write as I dot data, because it is stored in the data variable, data dot decode, because it is of byte type, and also it is of the Unicode type Unicode encoded data. So for this we will specify the encoding format. So we will use the i.data.decode, and I will specify the UTF-8 encoding, which is the very universal one, and the PyZ bar also uses this encoding. We can try with other encoding also, but for now we will use the UTF-8 encoding. So i.data.decode UTF-8 for i in Q data, and at last you can join the string. If you don't want to get the value in a list, like this one will return all the specified data in a list. So see, hey, this video is made by me at 1:30 p.m. and the original input data is also same. So we have extracted that particular data only which we require, not the bunch of data out of which we have to find where the data is, right? So for this we have returned the list as a list. We have returned the data as a list, but if you want to get it as a string, what you can do is you can simply use the join function. So here you can write dot join and res. So you will get it as a string value. So this is the only inputted data that we have encoded inside the QR code image, and we have extracted successfully. And if you want to see what QR code image we generated, so you can visualize it here also. Like for that you can import the matplotlib. So I'm importing matplotlib. It's purely optional. Okay, if you want to see what kind of image it generated, you can also navigate to your folder where you are writing this code and see what how QR code is generated there. Like what is the back color and what is the fill color, what you have specified, whether it is of that type or not. Okay, and if you want to visualize it in the editor only, so you can visualize it. So I'm just visualizing it using the matplotlib. So import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and here you can just visualize plt dot im show im, and you can provide the cmap. I want to visualize it as a black and white, so cmap as a grayscale, or rather you can specify it. So yes, this is what our image generated. But the thing is, one thing you might have noticed, that we have created the QR code image with the back color of a cyan, but it showed the back color as a yellow. This is because we are using the grayscale color map here of the matplotlib. Let's see, what if we don't specify, then also it's specifying the yellow background. And if you use the cmap is equal to, you can specify any cmap here if you know what kind of cmap the value it takes. So see, we have got the value error here. So these are the CMAP options, which you can put it here and get the desired result. So I'm just specifying here as gray. And see, this is what our QR code image looks like. And if you have any doubt regarding your QR code image, you can also extract the text using any mobile app also, which reads the QR code and see whether the data is same or not. But using Python and using the PyZ bar, it definitely gonna work. Okay, so this is how we can generate and read a QR code image, put the data inside it. You can also do it randomly also, or in real time also you can make it. You just take the random input and you can specify what data you can you want to provide, and subsequently you can generate the QR code and also read the QR code. So I hope you like this video, and if you have liked this video, please like, share and subscribe. And for more interesting videos, please subscribe to my channel. See you for the next video.